everyone. I'm Fulzia.
And I'm Kothar.
And we're the founders of Coup de Cloth. That's a true statement. Don't worry about her face. That was a true statement. We are the founders of Coup de Cloth. Welcome to our channel. If you haven't been here before, we devote most of our time to, well, not most of our time. That's a dream. But
a lot of our time. A good amount of our time. So to natural skincare and hair care products and the promotion of local brands and makers all over the world.
So our channel, outside of just introducing you to different products, we tell you how to use them, how you can DIY your own things if you don't want to make your own products. And today we wanted to tell you about a recent trip we went on and some of the products we discovered.
So this time around we went to Kenya. And Fulzia has a whole bunch of products that I actually haven't seen yet that I want to find out what she bought.
So this is kind of like a haul slash first look. So she gets to show you her reaction, and I'm going to try to keep a straight face the entire time. So
yeah, I'm not very reactive, so we'll see how this goes.
That's not true. You just have to look in her eyes. So I got kind of a mixture of different products, so some things you can do DIYs with. All things from, well, most of the things are from local makers or from local stores that sell natural organic products. So I'm going to show it to her for the first time, and I'm going to mess with her a little bit. So just bear with us. We went to a couple of different places. So we actually went to visit a brand where they walked us through their workshop and showed us how they make the products. We also went through what I'd call to a maker's market. And there were people who made all sorts of things, whether it's natural products or like apparel, for instance. And then we also went to a couple of local shops that specialized in natural organic products. So I'm going to start. Hey, no peeking. No peeking. The first thing I want to show Kothar is from a brand called Mugsy's. So Mugsy's, they had, I'd say, three different products that I saw. I met them at a local market that we went to. They make a hair butter, a body butter, and then they also have a lip gloss. So before we do anything, I'm going to let Kothar open this one. So
what's this one?
Open.
Just all natural hair.
Don't even look at the ingredients. I want you to open it. Just open it.
Gotta use all my muscles. Oh, that's pretty.
Pretty. Smell it. What do you think?
A little strong.
What's in it?
Some essential
oil. Pop
quiz. Some essential oil. But it's a strong one.
Really? I didn't find it that strong.
I think it is.
Oh, okay. Oh, it's something I love and you don't love as much.
Lavender.
No.
Mm-hmm.
No.
Lemongrass.
Apparently she hates a lot of things that I love. She's going to keep going on this. So anyways, I actually couldn't wait. So I've already tried the body butter, but this is the body butter. So do you see the difference in them? So the hair butter is actually, it's more whipped, it's softer, and the body butter is denser. More dense. So it really is very dense. And then the hair butter, you see it's like more whipped and creamy. Thinner and a little silkier. So one
To help with slip.
So there you go.
Right through.
So what I actually thought was interesting about this brand Mugsy's is that they actually have the exact same ingredients in both of these butters. The difference is the proportion of the ingredients that they use based off of the intended end use. So
I like tea tree oil.
I will disclose what's in here. So shea butter, cocoa butter.
Oh, that one has cocoa butter?
Did I skip one? Okay. Yeah. So, my bad. There's one different one in here. So, Kothar, read your ingredients first.
It's shea butter, castor oil, coconut oil, beeswax, tea tree oil, and eucalyptus. Oh, that was the one you were thinking of because I don't like eucalyptus.
So, they both have different mint oils, but this one is shea butter, cocoa butter, castor oil, coconut oil, beeswax, and peppermint oil and vanilla oil. So, again, very, very similar base ingredients, the main ingredients of shea butter and castor oil and coconut oil, but layering a couple of different things based off of the end use. And because I bought this, they actually gave me one of their lip glosses for free.
Oh, that's what I was smelling. This one also has vanilla in it as well.
So, what's that? Basically, all of the ingredients except for one or two are the exact same.
Yeah.
So, I've already started using this body butter. It works really well. And
no patience.
I couldn't wait. She was taking too long. But in any case, I like a really dense like moisturizer. I have very dry skin. So I already started using this body butter. I've basically been using it every time I get out of the shower. And my skin has stayed soft the entire day. Yes. I haven't tried the hair butter yet. But what I'm going to do is scoop some out and send Kothar to try that this week.
No, it would be a really good leave-in because I use creamy leave-ins when I do my wash and goes underneath the gel. So this would actually probably work quite well as one of my leave-ins. Excited to try it.
And what I like about these products is I know one is called a hair butter and one's called a body butter, but you could really use both of them for either purpose, depending on what your goal is. Like if you're doing a twist out, you could totally get that body butter and go to town and do like a really sleek twist out with it. So I love products that are multi-purpose like that, that you can do anything with. So
what's next?
Let's see what's next. So I'm going to stick to the things that I got at like fairs or from local makers first. So the next brand I want to talk to you about is Kiara Organics. So the founder of this brand, she was inspired to start something when she had her daughter. Her daughter was sensitive to some of the products and or allergic to them, and she wanted to be able to give her safe products that would help with her hair or skin. So that's what inspired this brand, the beginning of this brand. It's a small line with a very focused collection of products for your hair and your body. So I have to remember, actually, before I go there, I'll show you what I got. So first is this shea nut oil. So this is the oil basically from the shea tree. And as you can see, I've already been using this. I cheated. So what I did was...
Always.
She just took too long. So what I did was during the week for my wash and goes, in order to maintain them, actually, before I go to bed, I spritz my hair with a little bit of water. I pour this in my hand and I use it. I rub it on my hair and then twist my hair up in sections. So this has been helping me to maintain my wash and goes. It's really dense, not as dense as castor oil, but just pour just a very small bit out and you'll see exactly what I mean.
No, it's not.
I think so. Like when you put it on your hair, like a little bit goes a long way.
I use wild root beer oil on my hair.
Okay, so that really goes a long way. Sorry, inside jokes.
No, it's actually, it's good.
No, it's really nice. And I've actually never used shea nut oil by itself. So neither. I was excited to try this. And now my biggest concern is, where am I going to get more if this runs out? I'm really worried about this. So if anybody's listening and you have some you want us to try, I mean,
send it our way.
I won't be mad. So the other thing I got is this body butter. So they're honestly, if I bought every body butter that was available, I would have had no room in my suitcase. I would have had to pay for overweight things. So I had to like rein it in. But this is another body butter I bought. I'm not going to tell Kothar what's in it yet. I just want you to smell it first. And try
it. I'm not going to look at the label. Does it have that eucalyptus in it again?
She's so bitter about eucalyptus. Just try it. All right, I'll hold this.
Okay. It's very, very dense. Actually, a little difficult to move around, too. You have to, like, massage it and warm it up.
Yeah, so full disclosure, this has been sitting in a cold room for, like, as long as I've been waiting for her to come take this video. Just full disclosure. But it is like in a solid state right now, so you do have to work it in a little bit. Side note, my hands are going to be so moist by the time this video is over. But this is actually the shea and mango body butter. So it's a combination of shea butter and mango butter. It's really simple ingredients. There isn't a lot of extra in here. The only additional things they have are marula oil and a small amount of essential oils. So again, keeping it really, really simple. But this was another one of the body butters that we decided to try.
Yeah, I think this one would be particularly good for people with very dry skin or sensitive skin in the colder months. Or if you have dry cuticles that tend to peel in the cold months, if you massage that particular type of butter around it before you go to bed at night, you will wake up with very, very nice soft hands.
Ooh, I see some.
I'm oily on the other hand, so I probably would not use as much of that.
All right, so they had two different things. One was a body butter and one was a body balm. So this is the body balm.
Can I see?
Colder wants to see. I guess I'll show her. Just smell it first. Guess it's in.
Oh, this has a nice smell.
All right. I finally pleased her. That was a little too difficult, but
oh my God. It has a very nice smell. It must be the honey.
Yeah. So this one is shea and honey. Mm-hmm. How does it feel?
Well, I'm running out of arm space right now, but let's try this.
I didn't think that through, but I loved when I smelled this one. I had to buy it. This was the first thing I picked up from them.
This one is silky smooth.
And like this is a must have. So, all right, this has, outside of the shea and the honey, it has aloe, avocado oil, and olive oil. So again, super, super simple ingredients from Kiara Organics. And those are the three things I bought there. So honestly, all three of those are wins for me. Everything is incredibly moisturizing. I might share this with her. Maybe.
That's going home with me. She just doesn't know it yet.
Everyone can dream, and that's okay. That is all right. So a couple of other things from some of the local makers. So another brand, and we actually couldn't get to them because they're much further away. But this brand, Cinnabar Green, they also sold their products at the hotel we stayed at. It was all the toiletries they had. So I was really excited to stay someplace that used all natural and organic products as what was there. So this is something I may or may not have taken with me from the hotel. It's a lemon and honey soap. Mm-hmm. I don't know if you can smell it through the wrapper, but you can try.
Yeah, I can. It's nice, actually. It's really nice.
Like, they had shampoo.
It's
they
very
had
refreshing.
Their entire line, basically your shampoo, your body wash, the lotion, everything in this hotel was from this brand. And then we happened across this store that sold their products, so we bought this face mask. Check it out.
Face mask. I do like face mask.
My hands feel so good right now. What do you think?
It smells like dirt. But in a good way. Just in a good way. not in a bad way. Just that it smells very rich.
It smells very earthy. Do you want to tell them what's in it?
Let's see. Since I clearly suck at guessing what's in these things. That's what I was smelling. Bentonite. So smelly. Bentonite clay, water, macadamia, lavender, vitamin E. You could use this.
Just read the ingredients.
Vitamin E are the main ingredients in this one. But no, it's really, really nice. Have you tried it yet?
No. See, I didn't try everything. I just, you know, usually I use just coconut oil coming out of the shower on my body, but I ran out and I knew I had all of these things, so there was no point of going and buying more coconut oil when I had every body butter on the planet. It just didn't make sense.
No, this one is nice. It'll be really good at pulling impurities out of your pores. It's a great way to end the week or a really, really late night when you want to get off that makeup that's deep-seated in your pores if you've been wearing it all day. This is a good option.
So you know what I was just thinking? We have a ton of masks. Like, a ton. Mm-hmm. From a bunch of different brands we've discovered. And, like, I'm not even exaggerating. From brands all over the world, we have masks. That shelf back there is, like, loaded with different masks.
And that's really not even all of them.
Cool ones that you can mix together. Some that come with their own mixing ingredients. We should do something with that.
We should do something with that.
I'm going to have to think about that one.
Mask. Have a sleepover. All girls in different masks.
That's the only way to get them all tested at once.
Well, it is, exactly. And what girl doesn't love a sleeping mask? Like, seriously.
So, if anybody's trying to find a new friend and you want to come do some masks with us, we'll think about that one. But we'll keep going on the other products. So, this one, I actually... So, there was a new mall. I don't remember the name of it. I can put it in the description box below. And that's where I found a couple of different products, actually. So I found this there. I found the mask there. I found basically everything here I found at this natural product store in this mall. So this, and I was really trying to focus on purchasing things that were made either by local makers and or using local ingredients. So this is from a brand called Lulu Life. And it's actually made using South Sudan shea, and it's a body and face butter. And again, one thing I liked here was that a lot of the products you could use basically from head to toe. So I actually haven't opened this. I haven't smelled it. I know nothing about it. So I'm just surprised. Thought it was interesting, and it was the first product I saw from South Sudan, so I wanted to try it. There you go. You get to smell it and test it first. Guess what?
I'm running out of arms.
Creates the scent, though. It looks really smooth, though.
It does look smooth. I don't know if you can see that, but it's very, very white and very smooth. It's actually not a strong scent at all, actually.
Can I smell?
It's not strong.
It's difficult to
pull out what's in it.
Ooh. Feel this.
Yeah, it's like a balm. It's almost like the one we tried a few minutes ago.
No wonder you can use this on your face, too. You know those, like, silicone face primers?
Yeah.
This legitimately feels like that.
But nicer. Definitely, yeah. Nicer. And it, more luxurious feeling.
It feels like you'd put it on your skin before you put on makeup, and you're like, what is it called? Oh, my gosh. Not Photoshopped, but when it's all blurry.
Not Photoshop.
You know what I'm talking about? Yes.
Airbrushed.
The main ingredient in here is shea. I will leave it at that. It's basically pure shea butter. And Kulthar, you pronounce the essential oil.
The essential oil. Oh, Yiling?
Is it Yiling? What if I said Lang Lang?
That is not what it is. It's Yiling.
I'll laugh at my own jokes, Yiling. Too. Anyway. It's what?
Yiling.
Yiling, but Yiling. No, you have to say Yiling if it's Yiling.
You know what? Y-L-A-N-G. Twice.
That's Lang Lang.
It's not Lang Lang.
Okay, bye.
Anyways. Next.
Anyways, so the only thing we were saying here was this face butter feels really smooth. If you're not one for primer or too cheap to buy a primer. I'm not hating. It does have a bit of a
tackiness to it, so, like, it might be great to layer makeup on top of.
Yeah, it feels like the...
Like a silicone primer. It feels like
you would get that airbrushed look by using it. Just make sure you don't use too much.
Yes. A little goes a long way. Unless you like sloppy concealer.
I wish you would have told me that a long time ago.
You know what? Next.
All right. So just a couple of other things that we got. This was at this organic store. So they sold beauty products, skin products, hair care products, food. It was everything but natural and organic. So a couple of other things I wanted to try. And this is actually made in India, I think. It's a hair treatment powder.
Hair wash and treatment. 100% organic fruit and seed powder. How do you use it? It looks like you just mix it with water and slap it on your hair.
So I feel like this is one of those things that's going to be really good for this sleepover party we haven't planned out yet. So, hold on. Let me just tell you guys what's in it. So, it has amla fruit powder, rita fruit powder, shikakai seed. She doesn't believe. These are the real words, I promise. Shikakai seed powder.
Yeah, that's right.
It's all organic. And basically, they said the amla helps prevent the graying of hair. The Rita is good for your health. And the Shikakai, if somebody knows how to pronounce that, just let me know. I know I'm wrong. I know I'm wrong. It promotes hair growth and strengthens the hair roots. So it seems like it would be a good treatment for almost anyone, and the products seem relatively safe and harmless, even if you had any sorts of allergies or anything. Mm-hmm. A couple of things. So this here, it says make a paste with water. Sometimes I cheat and I add things to my paste. So I might use a different ingredient. Like you could use aloe vera juice. You can like water down some yogurt a little bit. Or you could even use like milk, like coconut milk instead. And those things would just amp up the effects of something like this and amp up the moisturizer.
Nice. All right, come on, get to the boxes.
Okay. So, I really want to dye my hair, but I'm terrified of
it falling out.
To be honest. I'm like really, really terrified. And I feel like the only way to get the true color I want is with like bleach or something. So, I don't know if that's going to happen. And honestly, I don't even know if like something like these would necessarily work. Sorry. So I got these two organic dyes. It's from the same company, Radico. So I figured I could do one and then put the other one on top of it. And maybe then it'll get a lighter color. If you color hair and you know it doesn't work like that. Just taking my dreams away from me. So I got these two shades. One is copper brown.
And the other one is golden blonde.
So my theory was go a little lighter with the copper brown, patiently wait and see and hope something happens, and then try it again with the golden blonde. We may have to shoot a video for all about dyeing your hair safely. I feel like that might be...
That could be good. Let us know if you think that's a good video to do.
All right, so...
And don't laugh if all our hair fall out.
That's actually not funny, but we're going to try this.
Oh, I just noticed the ingredients that are in this are also the key ingredients that you can find inside of both of these dyes, actually. Both have amla. They have methi. Reki?
We're going to have to look up some of this stuff. We'll put notes on what these things are.
Nevertheless, it's a seed. It's a type of seed. But also, what probably is giving you the color in here is the henna. There's a lot of henna in here, and indigo as well.
So it's probably the combination of those things that give your hair different casts, depending on the amount that's in either of these.
Yeah, but these would not be permanent dyes.
So we'll see. But if I bleach my hair, I'm just joking, guys. So really quickly, just a couple of other things. They have an abundance of avocado in Kenya. The avocado there is absolutely delicious. So I thought it was essential to get some avocado oil made in Kenya. So we have some here. I got avocado oil for that main reason. And
it's a very moisturizing oil. It's not as dense as like your castor oils, but it's more of a consistency like olive oil. Actually, it might even be a little bit lighter than olive oil, but very, very nourishing for your hair. And avocado in general, there isn't a part of that fruit that isn't good for you, to be honest.
So,
even if you don't like avocado, like I don't like avocado.
I don't trust people who don't like avocado. Every time she says that, I just get uncomfortable.
But like, I'll put it on my hair. I just don't like to eat it, really.
All right. So the last two things. One, a friend of ours took us to Super Cosmetics. And one of the products I found there, it's another shea-based product. So it's actually a handmade hair bar. And it has clay and shea in it. Clay and shea.
I've been a little bit hesitant to try hair bars just because at least the hair bars in the past, they were always very stripping and drying of your hair. I've never tried a natural hair bar to compare it to, but it'll be interesting to see what happens.
So I, today, for the first time, used a hair bar on my hair. It wasn't this one because this isn't opened yet. I used one from a local New York brand called Saliander. It's their mint and milk bar. And I just randomly grabbed it while I was in the shower because we had it there anyway. I was like, it's only mint and milk. It must be pretty good. And I used it and it was wonderful. It was fine. So I think we should try
clay shampoo bar.
I might have to convert you. We'll see. All right. So the very last thing, and when I said we met a brand and went to their workshop, I was specifically talking about Sabuni. So I don't know if you could see that, but Sabuni, they make handmade soaps using mostly local ingredients. So they have a couple of different ones. We got samples of three different ones. All of their bars you can use on any part of your body. So you can use it on your hair, on your face, on your skin. So we actually got two different things, and this one was kind of like a bonus, let's try this. We already used it while we were on vacation, actually. This one was incredibly moisturizing. This is the one I wanted to try specifically for my hair and skin type. And actually, my husband tends to suffer with like eczema and things like that. And they specifically recommended this one for him for his hair and body. So based off of their recommendations, these are the ones we decided to try. We're finished all of the products, but I saved this one for last because this would be a good segue into us just telling you a little bit more about what our future intent is with our channel and what we want to bring to you.
So we've decided that since we have a strong focus on education, and we think it's a very, very important part of what we do and making sure that people understand what's in their products and what's good for you and what's good for your skin and what's available to you in nature right around where you live.
And I think also what we've really enjoyed on this journey of discovering brands is being able to tell stories, and not only the stories of the makers, but the stories of the people and the communities that we're visiting and exploring and that they're welcoming us into. So with all of that being said, it's really to say we're going to change the format a bit of the information that we present to you. Our goal is to monthly, bi-monthly, we're still working out the details in the production, but to bring you more in-depth videos, more documentary, think Vice style, that really paints a picture and tells the story of the products
and the makers. And the makers is the key part, just because I think that's what captured us the most, is their stories behind how they came to their products and how they're giving back to their communities and how they want to bring you in. They want you to come into their community and see what their lives are like and realize that we're more connected than we know.
So our first series is actually going to be featuring the makers of Sabuni. So we got to spend quite a bit of time with them learning about their brand, but also learning about just all the economic factors impacting Eastern Africa, the resources that exist there, some roadblocks that they have, and opportunities. So we really wanted to tell the full story about this brand and about our trip. And we feel like changing the format and getting a little bit like down in the details will be much more helpful to everyone.
That's it.
So until then, if you like this video, don't forget to give it a thumbs up. If you aren't already subscribed, don't forget to subscribe. That way you'll get a notification, or you could turn the notifications on, when we post our first video in our new docu-series. I'll try to be cool and say it like that.
No, don't do that.
I try.
Okay, stop.
In case. Anyways. All right, guys. Anything else?
Nope, we're good.
All right. Thanks for watching. We'll see you in the next video.
Do you want to take a look? All right. Yo, what's up?
I'm not taking that out. I'm not taking that out. Yes, you are taking that out.
Anyways, here we go.
I'm not taking it out. Anyways.
Okay, I got the perfect one. Hey, guys!
Jeez.
I'm joking. What were we talking about?
Anyways.